The only person who can deliver enthusiasm to a candidate is the candidate himself or herself. And so John McCain is going to have to close the deal. It's not going to be enough to say, you know, I'm better than Hillary, I'm better than Obama. If he really wants the kind of enthusiasm you're talking about, he's going to have to generate it himself by convincing them that he really cares about their issues, and he's not going to compromise on their issues. And even when he disagrees with them on things like McCain-Feingold, he respects their right to disagree and is respectful of them and not condescending and not dismissive. That's going to be very important, and I think that's far more important than who he picks as a running mate. And you haven't asked me, but if Senator McCain were to ask me, who should he pick as a running mate, I would say, Senator, do you really want to win? And I guess he would say yes. And I would say, then you need to do whatever it takes to get Condoleezza Rice on the ticket with you, because you're going to be running against a tide of either the first woman president or the first African-American president, and the best way to break that tide is to have as your running mate the first woman African-American vice president.
Richard Land, you say many smart things. That's almost the smartest thing I've ever heard you say. That's absolutely right, and I haven't thought about that.
In addition to which, she is one of the most impressive human beings that Americans will ever meet.
All right. What do you think of that, Evan?
Condoleezza Rice is a very impressive human being who is possibly the worst national security advisor in history in the first term of the Bush administration. And that, I'm not so sure McCain wants to have her record on that raked over the coals.
Go past Condoleezza Rice. How about finding an African-American woman? There are a lot of smart, accomplished African-American women in America.
Yeah.
In business, for example. Business.
But where does that get you votes? I mean, as a campaign operative, I would like a VP that delivers a state. You know, Condi Rice, I'm
like,
a huge
tell me what state. Tell me what state.
Tell me what state
Dick Cheney delivered.
Wyoming? Zero. And it was a close call. Would things have been different with somebody else? How about Norm Coleman? What about Senator Coleman? Can he deliver Minnesota? You know, that would be a big thing in terms of the chess game that is 272 electoral votes.
How about Martinez delivering Florida? But I would say that Condoleezza Rice would deliver votes everywhere. I would say that Condoleezza Rice delivers votes in, don't forget, she's from Birmingham.
She delivers votes. We claim her.
She delivers votes lots of places.
My experience has been trying to geographically balance the ticket, or trying to put somebody on there that's generically going to drive votes doesn't work. I mean, they had the very best contrast ever with Benson and Quayle, and we learned once again the VP nominee doesn't drive votes outside of that person's one state where I think they can drive votes.
Do you believe that George Bush would have won re-election if he dropped Dan Quayle and picked another running mate, Ed?
Well, it was probably too late in the game by then. I mean, Ross Perot's entry had sort of scrambled the deck in such a way where it was impossible. But, you know, who knows?
All right, we're on this thing about vice president. Let's see it through.
Let me put in my vote for Mike Huckabee, and for two reasons. I mean, one, obviously, he is the Republican candidate besides John McCain, who's left standing right now, who has demonstrated that he actually has a huge amount of appeal in a lot of states and among a lot of constituencies that McCain does not. But actually, more importantly than that, Mike Huckabee is the only candidate in the Republican field who has spoken with a degree of passion and a degree of conviction about the most important issue in America right now, which is the economy. And this is an issue where John McCain was quoted notably in New Hampshire saying, I don't really understand the economy. I bought Alan Greenspan's book, but I haven't read it yet. I mean, more than delivering a state, it would be useful for John McCain to get schooled a little bit in a kind of economic language that he's going to need to speak in this campaign.
Let me explain to you that, Heilemann, that of all the reasons that Richard Land would like to see Mike Huckabee on the ticket, even though he prefers Condoleezza Rice, it is not because of his position on the economy. Am I right?
You're right. Although I've known Mike Huckabee for 28 years. He's a great guy. I think he would be an impressive figure on the ticket. I'm a little concerned that perhaps the country, the 20% in the middle that decide our elections, Because let's face it, 35 to 40% of this country is going to vote for the Republican nominee if it's Mickey Mouse, and 35 to 40% are going to vote for the Democratic nominee if it's Donald Duck. Yeah. And so the elections are decided by the 20% in the middle,
right,
who are the least engaged, and they vote for sometimes odd reasons. And I hate to say this because I'm a Southern Baptist minister, but I'm not certain that among that 20%, that they're not going to hesitate about voting for a Southern Baptist minister, even though he has been governor of a state, to be the number two person on the ticket and to be vice president of the United States. I mean, I hate to say that, but I think there is still enough of a prejudice against ordained people in the public policy process that might be problematic. But look, I love Governor Huckabee. He's a great guy.
All right, but
let
me ask one question.
What about John Kasich? Where is he? John Kasich, where is he? He shores up.
He's on the radio. I tell you where he is. He's on the radio.
He helps. he helps. He's young. He served in Congress. He would help in Ohio. You know, there's a lot of good people out there.
How about
both politically and from a policy standpoint, they can fill some gaps.
Okay, well, let me just ask this. We got the possibility for the first time in a long time that a senator is going to win the presidency.
It's probably going to happen.
Exactly. So therefore, shouldn't the nominees, if they're senators, reach out for someone who's not of Washington?
Well, it might help. Well, but, you know, Charlie, I'm thinking about the last time I can remember that a vice presidential nominee probably did make a decisive difference. It was when Jack Kennedy picked Lyndon Johnson. He would not have won Texas without Lyndon Johnson.
He drove a state. You're exactly right.
Right. We agree. Evan, you have any nominees for us?
No. To tell you the truth, I'm usually wrong when I predict one, and I don't think it matters very much.
Oh, I intend to agree with that, too. Join us online at charlierose.com.